Ladies and gentlemen, coming up here on the Pro Wrestling Show, talk about the Elimination Chamber. You know, Elimination Chamber, 6 Raw superstars, 6 SmackDown superstars, 2 Elimination Chamber matches, 1 for the WWE Championship, and the other is for number 1 contendership to meet Roman Reigns for the WWE Universal Championship, and many more matches to come on Predict Outcome. And we'll have hot topics as the Supreme Court could landmark a mark case for WWE in the CTE case, and what's next for Lars Sullivan. All this and more on the Pro Wrestling Show starts right now. Hello everyone, welcome to this edition of the Pro Wrestling Show. I'm your host as always, Kenny Dix here. Glad you can join us here for our special Pro Wrestling Show for the Elimination Chamber. No Raw report, no SmackDown report. We'll get to the AEW tidbit news on hot topics, but this is the Elimination Chamber's Predict the Outcome. But first thing first, join in the conversation using the hashtag ProWrestling here on Connect, and don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe is caring. Tell a friend, call a friend, hit that subscribe button so you won't miss a thing. As we talk about the Elimination Chamber, Predict the Outcome. As you know, Elimination Chamber streaming live on the WWE Network, and the Elimination Chamber, 10 tons of steel, 6 miles of length. I mean, the Elimination Chamber, this demonic structure that's been in the WWE since 2002. Who can forget the first historic Elimination Chamber match at Survivor Series, where Shawn Michaels defeated Triple H and others to win the World Heavyweight Championship in their first ever Elimination Chamber. You know, Elimination Chamber is historic. After every year, Elimination Chamber gets better and better with unpredictability, elements of Royal Rumble, elements of Survivor Series, and elements of War Games. Elimination Chamber is dead. All right, we have 5 fantastic Elimination Chamber matches. Not Elimination Chamber, but 2 of them is included in the Chamber. Let's get started with the first match, where it's for the WWE Championship. Champion Drew McIntyre defends his championship in the Elimination Chamber against 5 former WWE champions. The 5 former WWE champions are AJ Styles, Kofi Kingston, Sheamus, Randy Orton, and Jeff Hardy. All 6 of these men got some guy experience in the Chamber. All of them got Chamber experience. So this is a wild card. This past week on Raw, it was a gauntlet match to see who was going to be the last person standing to be entered last in the Elimination Chamber. It went down to Sheamus and champion Drew McIntyre. McIntyre thought he had Sheamus where he won him until Sheamus hit the bro kick and pinned the champion. So Sheamus is the one that's going to be last entering the Elimination Chamber for the WWE Championship. So, like I said, who's going to start it? I believe Drew McIntyre will start it, and AJ Styles. Or it might be Drew McIntyre and Randy Orton. And look for Drew to retain his championship. A lot of rumors and reports that Sheamus might win it, and it might be a program between Sheamus and Drew heading on to WrestleMania, which that makes more sense if Sheamus does win. But I put my money on Drew McIntyre to win the Elimination Chamber and retain his WWE championship heading on the fast lane. It's the fast lane to WrestleMania continues. Also, speaking of that, on Raw, Lashley defends his United States Championship against 2 challengers that's been gunning for him for the past several months. Lashley defends against Keith Lee and Riddle, with MVP in his corner. Lashley has been an unstoppable force as late, as calling himself the Juggernaut, one time the Destroyer, Lashley, walking Armageddon, I'd like to say, Lashley. Keith Lee has been seen on Raw due to the fact that he's been engaged and he's been quarantining himself since his fiance, reckoning Miriam, has been stricken with COVID. Well, Keith Lee should return. Matt Riddle has been a pain in MVP in the Hurt Business. So look for, I want to say Riddle to win. Riddle has Lashley's number, and look for a program between Riddle and Keith Lee going forward. Lashley might go for the title. Never know. Also, the Women's Tag Team Championship just been announced as Nia Jax and Shayna Baszler defend the women's tag championships against Sasha Banks and Bianca Belair. This is something that's happened before. Two unlikely contenders where Sasha and Bianca, Bianca has not determined if she's gonna get a shot at the SmackDown Women's title. She hasn't determined her decision. So Bianca and Sasha will go against Shot Nia and Shayna. Nia and Shayna has been, people been gunning for them. On Raw, you have Lana and Naomi. On NXT this past week, you had Raquel Gonzalez and Dakota Kai, who won the Women's Dusty Tag Team Cup. Cut a promo on them while they was there and talked about Nia's hole. And then you got Sasha and Bianca Belair talking the same way. So look for Nia and Shayna to regain their titles. And look for a dramatic ending between Sasha and Bianca. So look for that. All right. That ends the first half of Predict the Outcome. When we return, we'll have more Predict the Outcome. But coming up, we'll have hot topics. Don't go nowhere. This is the Pro Wrestling Show after this. Show. I'm your host as always, Kenny Dix here. Glad you can join us at the Pro Wrestling Show. We'll have predicted outcome later on in the show, but right now it's Hot Topics. On Hot Topics this week, we talk about what's going on with the WWE. Now, this coming up this week, WWE and third-party apps. WWE basically saying that the superstars that engage with third party, just like how they did the Twitter ban that led to Serena Vega getting fired, because she did refuse to not give up her Twitter account. She said she was making way more money than she was in WWE. Well, WWE is doing the same thing, meaning that if you kind of unsolicited promote something on your social account, social media, like if you're, say you promote Oreos without WWE acknowledgement, WWE can suspend you and fine you and lead to your termination. So it's a lot. So a lot of people not upset. I'm happy about that. And WWE not making real good. Well, you know how that go. WWE saying they trying to catch in their superstars doing it. Got to be under the WWE umbrella, not under your own umbrella. Well, you under WWE. That's what WWE trying to say. Also, this past week on Raw, Lacey Evans revealed that she was pregnant. Now, storyline, she made it feel like revealed that she's pregnant with Ric Flair's child, where the Nature Boy was so elated and excited. But in real life, Lacey Evans is pregnant and she's suspected to take a sabbatical and take maternity leave while she is pregnant. So I don't know what they're going to go with the story. Like Ric Flair is going to be Lacey Evans' baby daddy. It's trying to confuse who wouldn't be, but that's how it be. Congratulations, Lacey Evans and Summer are going to be a big sister. Also, the issue between Sammy Guevara and AEW Impact Wrestling has been resolved. They said that Sammy Guevara was supposed to go to Impact from AEW. That's how Matt Hardy wrestling his boys and they're in the Good Brothers making talent swaps. Sammy Guevara was supposed to join the Decay. Sammy turned that down. Sammy was supposed to win the X Division title and bring it back to AEW. Impact turned that down. So it was like conflicting reports, but no one can come up with a conclusion. So Y2J had to step in. So also, speaking of Y2J, Chris Jericho received his YouTube plaque for his YouTube. So congratulations for Chris Jericho for receiving his milestone 100,000 subscribers on YouTube. Well, speaking of that, Y2J's, they say sources allegedly that Y2J's wife and his mother-in-law was part of that Capitol riots when some Capitol terrorists decided to go to the Capitol and try to you know how that goes. Try to ambush and try to take down the government. Well, they said Jericho's wife and mother-in-law was there, but they said they was at the parade, and they said Antifa was the one that started that, not them. You know that there go. Speaking of that, MLW stars Arion Blake and Impact star TJP are engaged. Now, this comes out the fact that Blake renounced that she was pregnant with TJP's key child. So, Arion Blake, TJP, engaged. Also, coming out that news, Eli Drake, now known as LA Knight, signed with WWE. He'll be part of the NXT brand. So, Eli Drake coming to WWE. I just hope they do right by him. And Eli should know better than anybody that, well, look what happened to EC3. Without, he had the potential. He was the appealing, the star and stuff. And Vince McMahon shitting on him. Then they did what they want to do. I hope they don't do that to Eli. But Eli, brace yourself if that does happen. So it can happen. Also, WWE confirms that Alexa Bliss and Charlotte Flair will star on Punky Brewster. Punky Brewster now will be on the NBCU's streaming service, Peacock, where WWE is now going to be under Peacock as well as a channel, and you'll get WrestleMania and stuff. So they're trying to do that 1-2 punch with partnerships, which with the WWE stars merging into Peacock. Also, JR did a slip up on this week's AEW broadcast. JR said the WWE champion Kenny Omega. And JR kind of forgot that he was in the AEW. He was meant to say the AEW champion Kenny Omega by step the WWE champion. And Drew McIntyre took fun of it and poked at JR. And, all was good. Speaking of that, Conan, K-Dawg, big fan of K-Dawg. Big fan of, you know, what K-Dawg did. Did support his little Keeping Up the Podcast, Keeping 100 podcast. He was hospitalized on kidney issues. And we want to wish Conan speedy recovery, because K-Dawg, you are that. K-Dawg will get back and be talking more crap than ever before. So wish Conan the best. Let's see more. It said that they reportedly signed Millie McKenzie to a deal. So Millie McKenzie from the UK scene signed to a deal from WWE. It's a good look for Millie McKenzie. Also, a lot of people saying, why did Keith Lee push had ended? Keith Lee, we don't know yet. We just have to wait and find out at Elimination Chamber. I know he had his COVID issues. He was trying to quarantine himself. So, saying Vince McMahon don't see nothing in Keith Lee. I beg the difference. Keith Lee is just like how Mark Henry is. He be big and dominant, but he's trying to find his footing. He's trying to come on his own. So we have to wait and see how Keith Lee will do in wrestling. I'll be shocked if Keith Lee wins the United States title. But I think Matt Riddle is heading towards that direction, since they've been pushing toward Riddle a little bit. So look for Keith Lee to turn heel on Matt Riddle someday. Also, there have been a report that Bo Dallas, brother of Way Wyatt and son of IRS Mike Rotunda, is prepping himself for post-wrestling career after wrestling. Well, they're saying that he's looking at doing real estate, and his girlfriend, got her name. She's on the Riot Squad. But blonde chick, you know what I'm talking about. Blue Ride, Liv Morgan. They're saying that he knows it's inevitable that he will be released. So he's looking for that life after wrestling and start trying to get in the books into real estate. So ain't nothing wrong with that. As long as you know something, you want to do something. Also, WWE want to drops the storyline between Aaliyah and Murphy. They had that love story and WWE just dropped it. I kind of figure because Aaliyah was posting more pics of her boyfriend, which she on now, than Murphy. Murphy posting pics of his dog. So it was inevitable. I just didn't see it. Like, okay, what they going with this from the beginning? Next thing you know, it just dropped. You know, speaking of that, Rey Mysterio and Dominik was in tag team action on SmackDown. And I think now Otis and Chad Gable, I knew Chad Gable was healed. I knew they were gonna turn slowly turn Otis heel, and they did. Otis flatline, Rey Mysterio suffering the effects right now. That was this past, we're gonna smack that. Also, former WWE star Lars Sullivan, who's been in a lot of controversies himself, has now want to enter the boxing career. Lars now doing a boxing stage. Now Lars wants to be a boxer instead of a wrestler. So Lars Sullivan making his rounds as being a boxer. So we'll see. We'll keep an eye on that. Also, WWE attorney Jerry Devin. Everyone knows Jerry Devin. Issued a statement on the attempt of the CTE lawsuit. They said that lawsuit could lead to the Supreme Court. Could the Supreme Court get a case of wrestling and make it a landmark case? That would be the question. We have to wait and see. We have to wait and find out. Also, New Japan Wrestling is in talks with Axis to return to their program after Axis had got Quiet Impact Wrestling, and New Japan wasn't happy with that. New Japan didn't want no dealings, and now New Japan Pro Wrestling could be back in the picture with Axis, having their show on the networking channel. They might well just do a streaming network. One day when I get something like a streaming network and it makes a lot of money, just all the wrestling needs to be on screen. If WWE gonna drop the WWE network and gonna be to a Peacock and have their own little channel, little WWE network, or a lot of these other wrestling companies need to follow suit, because wrestling is a niche, but it hasn't grown as it should have grown. Like, anybody need to be getting on Netflix, this is a CBS little thing, Paramount Plus, or ABC, ESPN Plus, or something. Because I'm just telling you, streaming, YouTube or something, everything's going streaming, non-linear. So I guess they still think the big bucks are with the networks, but the networks are really suffering because of this streaming business. I'm telling you. All right, that is the hot topics. Let's move forward to the predicted outcome for WWE Elimination Chamber. All right, now we talked about what the matches and stuff. Let's talk about the final two matches that is too critical. I mean critical in this match, these two matches. The match is, all right, the Elimination Chamber for the SmackDown side, the number one contendership, where Jey Uso, Main Event Uso, Kevin Owens, who got an issue with Roman Reigns, King Corbin, Sami Zayn, who's been talking about this conspiracy, and Cesaro, who's been underutilized by WWE for the last 10 years, as well as Daniel Bryan, who has been underutilized by WWE in the last 5, 6, 7 years. Now, these six men gunning for a shot at the chance of fighting Roman Reigns for the Universal Championship, the Elimination Chamber. Now, this past week, Edge returned this 48 hours ago on SmackDown. Edge made it clear that he's going to wait and see who's going to be the champion after the Elimination Chamber. Edge thought that he didn't want no issue with Roman. He told Roman that you have to wait and see. You want me to pick you as a main event. Roman believes he thought he is the main event for WrestleMania. Goes against him. Well, these six men have something to prove. Where you have all these six men. Now, it's kind of tough. It's tough. Many people think Jey Uso is going to get the shot and go against Roman and feel conflicted. Now, I beg to differ. Because I see that Kevin Owens, I see Cesaro and Daniel Bryan. It's tough. It's a tough call to do. But if I had to pick one, I would say Cesaro will win the match and he will move on against Roman Reigns for the Universal Championship with Paul Heyman. So it'd be a single match for the Universal title. And I feel like Roman Reigns will retain his championship over Cesaro. Now, like I said, this is unpredictable. This is WrestleMania season. Anything can happen. So we have to wait and see, but I believe Edge will choose Roman Reigns going forward. So look for that. Look for some important critical moments in Elimination Chamber throughout these matches. Like I said, Sasha and Bianca, look for that being a critical moment. look for the women's match. Be critical. Look for the Raw match, Raw and Mixed Chamber match for the WWE title. Drew and Sheamus. Look for that being critical. Look for Roman, Edge, Cesaro, all the matches, all those elements being critical. Like I said, Elimination Chamber will be a phenomenal match. Kickoff for the road to WrestleMania. Like I said. So, for that, I've been your host, Kendrick Dick, saying so long, and we'll see you at Elimination Chamber. See you later.